In this video, I'm going to show you how to simulate the radiated emissions from this Duino Nano PCB. Specifically, I'm going to simulate the electric field or the so-called E-field emissions. I won't simulate the magnetic field emissions or so-called H-field emissions. Let's simply start with the simulation process. First, open the PCB with KiCad 6.0 to verify that you have the correct file. Now open FreeCAD. Copy this script into the Python console. If you're new to this channel, here is how to make the Python console visible. If you get an error message while importing, please download the FCAD PCB folder from the link I have provided in the description. Sadly, FCAD PCB has a bug that makes it import parts with self-intersections, so we have to correct the 3D model. For this, I will export the copper traces as a SDL file. And import them into the application Meshlab. We have to merge the vertices with this button. I choose a value of 30 micrometers, as this is slightly less than the copper thickness. Export the new SDL file. Name it as you want. You can now save and close the FreeCAD project. And now open the SDL file that was created with Meshlab. Go to the mesh editor, make sure that your object is selected, and now split it by its subcomponents. Now go to the parts editor and click here. Now mark all the objects and export them via this macro. You can create it by clicking on Macros and then on Create. Here is the code that you can copy. Once all bodies are marked, run the macro. And choose the subfolder where to store the step files. Close the FreeCAD project and create a new one. Now click on Import or hit Ctrl plus I on the keyboard. I suggest importing the step files in batches, as the app tends to crash if you try all at once. Mark the bodies, change to the parts workbench, and refine them. Now create the cube and make it cover the PCB. I made it 5 mm bigger than the PCB in X and Y direction and 10 mm bigger in Z direction. The box will be used as our infinity boundary for the simulation and represents our air volume around the PCB. I will place the box now, just copy my steps. Now mark all the copper traces and make a union of them. Now cut the traces out of the box. This step should now result in one body of air with the traces being cut out of it. For the electrostatic electric field simulation, we will only apply voltage at the surface of the copper. We can basically ignore that the material is copper. Export the body as a brep file. The brep file format is just faster to work with. You could also use STEP or IGES. They just load slower. Now open Salome. Change to the geometry editor and import the brep file by typing Ctrl plus E. Now change to the mesh editor. Make sure the body is marked and click on Generate Mesh. Follow my steps to generate the mesh via Gmsh. I reduce the element size to 0.1, which is 10 times finer than the standard setting of 1. Now start the computation. When you have errors, either your mesh size was not fine enough or your models are corrupt. For example, you might still have self-intersections or other problems. In order to make every trace and the box boundary selectable, split the mesh via this button. If you select 180 degrees, it will split the mesh by its bodies. Now mark the mesh. And export it as an UN file. You can close Salome now. As next step, we have to convert the mesh file into the internal file format of Elmer. Elmer is the tool that we will use to simulate the electric fields around the PCB. You could perform the next steps with the graphical user interface of Elmer, but sadly it's super laggy, so I will do all the remaining steps in the command line. Open the Windows command line and change the folder in which the UN file is stored. For this, type cd plus the folder name. Cd means change directory. Now type in this command. I found this command in the elmergrid manual. The 8 means that we want to convert the UN file, and the 2 means that we want to convert it to the Elmer file format. Once the command is executed, a new subfolder should have been created. These are the files that were generated with our command, and these two files I added manually. The elmersolver underscore start info only has 2 lines. The case.sif file is quite long. Please download it from the files that I shared. Everything that is in the text file can basically also be selected by the GUI. Here, for example, we see that the electrostatic solver was chosen, which is the same like in the GUI. Then we have the material here. I will now only change this part of the code. First, I want to select the face of the infinity boundary. This is the outer surface of the box. In order to do that, let's open the file entity.sif and let's also reopen the Salome project. In Salome, just make the faces visible until you see the box boundary. When you now look in the file entity.sif, you see that group 23 is now linked to the boundary condition 25. This is what we have to insert in our infinity boundary condition. Let's do the same now for the ground copper. It is group 22 in Salome, which is boundary condition 24. All the remaining boundary conditions are now our traces. They start with 1 and end with 62. We just have to skip boundary conditions 23 and 24. So we have in total 60 boundary conditions. You have to insert the quantity here. Now make sure that you're in the same folder as your case.sif file and run elmersolver. If everything was successful, a VTU file was created. You can open it with ParaView. Once you change the view to the potential view and make the box transparent, you should be able to see the traces in red. Red corresponds to 1 volt and blue corresponds to 0 volts or ground. If the simulation was correct, the traces should be in red. Let's now add ISO contours to see the electric field around the PCB. I will add 10 contours from 1 volt to 0.5 volts. As you see here, the PCB is quite a radiator. So let's change the lower voltage limit to 0.8 volts. I will change the color to the same limits as the contour via this button. So what do we see here now? These two areas radiate more than the rest. Let's add the copper layer now to find out why this part radiates so much more than the rest. As you see, here we have a lot of traces next to each other without any ground in between them. This will cause this bundle of traces to radiate. I won't really go into how much radiation is okay, but in general, different industries and countries have different limits. It is the same as, for example, some people can tolerate less noise from their neighbors than others. Besides radiation to the outer world, you will also cause interference between the signals. If the coupling is too strong, you will start seeing, for example, glitches. I hope you enjoyed watching. See you next time.